In this video, we are going to create realistic looking tears. If you want to use the same image, the download link is in the description. First we go to File, Open, and we open the photo of the girl. Then we go to the Layers panel and click the New Layer icon. Rename the layer, for instance, Tears. We can leave the layer fill type Transparency and click OK. Zoom in to one of the eyes by holding the Ctrl key and turning the mouse wheel. Select the Ellipse Select tool and draw a circle where you want to make the tear. Make sure you do not make it too big. Then we go back to the toolbox and select the Blend tool. We can leave the default settings as they are. The gradient should be foreground to background and the shape should be linear. Draw a line in the circle where you want the gradient to be. If this doesn't work the first time, we can do this again and again until it is to our liking. Now go to Select and hit None. Back to our Ellipse tool. We can use the scroll bars to move the image to the other eye. Here we make a second circle, but now a little bit smaller than the first one. Select the Blend tool again and make a gradient in the same way as we did in the first circle. Click Select and then None. Now we go to the mode and change the mode to Overlay. Go to Filters, click Distort and then Warp. Drag the dialog box to the side. Hover with the cursor over the edge, and when it changes in a little diagonal arrow, we can pull out the window. When the two little circles are not sharp, click one time in the preview pane and then hit Reset. Now they should be sharp. We can leave the settings as they are. Go to one of the tiers and pull it out a bit upwards. Maybe you need to do this two or three times to get a natural looking result. Do the same with the other tier. If it does not look good to you, click Reset and try again. Now click OK. Then we right-click on the top layer and select Alpha to Selection, so both tiers are selected. Go to the menu bar and hit Filters, and then Light and Shadow, and then Drop Shadow. Make the X as well as the Y offset 2 and change the blur radius to 7. Then click OK. Back to Select now and then again hit None. Make in the toolbox the paintbrush active. Select the brush with hardness 50. Change the opacity to around 30. Make sure that the size is 20. And make sure that the tear layer is selected. Now we are going to make a little trail where the tear streamed down on her face. We start with the biggest tear. If the result is not what we want, we can click Ctrl Z to undo this and try again. When we feel it's okay, we go to the other tier. Make, with the use of the bracket keys, the brush a little bit smaller. Then make a trail for this tier. When you are satisfied with the result, click the Smudge tool in the toolbox. We can leave the default settings as they are and zoom in to the left tier. Now we make a nice transition from the tier to the trail. When we select the drop shadow layer, we can also smudge the shadow a little bit. Press the spacebar, so the smudge tool changes into the move tool. Now we can move the image by moving the cursor without clicking. And when we let go of the spacebar, we have the smudge tool again. Activate the tear layer and smudge the tear into the trail. Click the drop shadow layer and smudge the shadow too. Then activate the layer of the girl. When this is done, we go to the toolbox again and click on the pencil. Then we change the foreground background colors so that white is our foreground color. Make the size of the brush 1. Zoom in or out by pressing the Ctrl key and turning the mouse wheel if necessary. Make some highlights in the tear as well as in the trail of the tear. We use Ctrl Z to make corrections and press the spacebar to move the image to the other tear. Here too we can make some highlights like we just did with the first tear. Satisfied? Go to View, Zoom, and then click Fit Image in Window. When we go to the Layers panel and activate the tear layer again, we can change the opacity to make the tears look more natural. When we select the drop shadow layer, we can do the same with the shadow. When we hit the bottom layer, we don't see the lines of the top layer anymore. And there we have it, two beautiful tears. And although our image looks a bit sad, I still hope you enjoyed this workshop. Thank you very much for watching.